what friends and peers think or might think, how they react or might react, can feel like everything sometimes. I'm SJ Lyon, and this is The Sex Talk. The next major influence on your sexuality after your family is your friends and peers. We're all familiar with the concept of peer pressure, although it's very often put in a negative context. Our friends and peers really can have our backs, even when our families don't. The same positive and negative influence can be applied to sex, love, and relationships. If you've ever had the sense that everyone was dating or in a relationship, or that everyone was having sex, you've experienced that powerful friend/peer influence. Almost all the sex information that gets spread around the most quickly is between you and your friends. That information may be accurate, sound, and helpful, or it can be wrong and downright hurtful. Do the words rumor and bullying sound familiar? An interesting way that information spreading among friends and peers can go awry is in the instance of pluralistic ignorance. When a majority of people assume that something is true for most people, when in fact it's not, and then they start to think or behave in that non-norm, sometimes even turning that non-norm into a norm. Let's revisit the notion that everyone is having sex. If you've ever experienced that thought, then you've likely also felt the pressure of being the only one not having sex. Of course, research would tell us that this is simply not true. Not all teenagers are having sex. Not even all 20-somethings are having sex. It's simply the power of friend and peer influence that gets us to think this way. Similar to the influence of your family, if friends and peers voice negative opinions towards some sexualities more than others, you will be less inclined towards those sexualities. Again, just like family, you can talk with friends and peers about just how what they're saying is affecting you. If you're nervous to do it on your own, bring in a trusted person who can help mediate the conversation. The fear of disapproval still applies to friends and peers, sometimes even more so than family. You owe it to yourself to live your life in a way that will make you happy. A big part of that happiness may involve a sexuality that you think friends and/or peers won't agree with, but at the end of the day, it's your happiness, not theirs. Any true friends will be able to accept you with open arms anyway. I'm SJ Lyon. This has been The Sex Talk on how friends and peers influence your sexuality. We'll cover the final major influencer on your sexuality in the next video. But in the meantime, you can hop over to my Instagram for even more content. If you enjoy my content, please consider visiting my Patreon and becoming a member. It'll really help me out. Until next time, stay safe, everyone.